Market TV.
Welcome to the Antonio Parkinson Project. I am Antonio Parkinson. Today's show, hot one, successful, educated, beautiful, single women on the show today. We don't understand why. We want to know why. Why is it that you have all of these great attributes, but yet you are still single? So stick around. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. The Antonio Parkinson Project.
Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Theirs was. Black Market Strategies, the new face of urban marketing. Let us plan your next big event or design that special flyer. Black Market Strategies specializes in street team deployment, flyer distribution, target marketing, product and event promotions, marketing and brand awareness, campaigns and election strategies. But wait, there's more. Media relations and solutions, business strategies, community marketing. We promote people, product, events, and brands. Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Give us a call today. 901-379-9101.
Skinny Fiber works. I've got my Skinny Fiber. Have you got yours? If you need to drop 5 pounds quickly, Skinny Fiber works. If you need to get in that little black dress, Skinny Fiber works. Skinny Fiber lets you eat less and feel full. It's 100% all natural. It detoxifies the body, improves blood sugar imbalances, and melts away stubborn fat. Get yours today. For more information, call 901-860-5110. Or you may check out our website at www.skinnyuniverse.com.
Black Market TV.
Welcome back to the Antonio Parkinson Project. I am Antonio Parkinson. Follow us right now, live. We're on Twitter. Tweet us. Let us know what you think. We'll tweet back. It's at Parkinson Project, P-A-R-K-I-N-S-O-N-P-R-O-J-E-C, without the T. Yes, we can spell. We just ran out of space with Twitter. So, but today's show, successful, educated, sexy, single women. Telling us why we don't, so we can get a better understanding of what goes on, what's happening in their life. So joining us right now, Rebecca Hart. Rebecca Hart, welcome to the Antonio Parkinson Project.
Hi, thank you so much for having me. I'm so delighted to be here.
Thanks for being here. We're excited about it. So we're excited about today's show. Hey, Rebecca, you fit the description. Sexy, mm-hmm. Successful,
absolutely,
educated. Uh-huh. But you are single. What's going on? Why are you single?
Well, Antonio, you know, it's just, for me, it was a matter of choice. Now, there was one point in my life when I did make the decision to have a relationship, and because of that decision, it put me in a position that delayed a lot of accomplishments and goals and dreams that I had on hand that I never got to accomplish. So I chose and made the decision to be single and remain single, especially as a single parent. I had to change perspective and put things in proper order. So my son became first, which is a priority, and because of that, I had to put education as a number one priority. But during this process of the past 8 years, I've had the time to cultivate the gifts and talents that God has put inside of me in order to bring to fruition the purpose that God had for me as an individual, as a sexy single woman. Because I know before a man even comes into the place, I have to have myself in position. Purposeful to add, to be a contributing factor to that marriage. And if I'm not in a position to do that, then what am I bringing to the table?
So let me jump in here real quick. So you couldn't fulfill your purpose with a mate or a male friend, boyfriend, you know, someone that you're dating? That purpose
at one point I thought I could, and that was the original intent of my marriage. I got married to someone that was on the same level with me at that time, and mm-hmm. I had the decision, or I had the perspective, that we were going to achieve our dreams together. However, that person had another agenda and kind of left me on a ringer. Well, I had to pick up the pieces and keep to do what I had to do at that point. So fortunately for some women, they do have the mates that can come in and they can build an empire and a team together. And I'm not knocking it. However, for my situation, that wasn't my case.
So let me ask you something. When you say you had a person that was on the same level, uh-huh. Levels change every day.
Exactly.
So has that level changed? Is that person not on the same level with you anymore? And what was that level back when you guys were on the same level?
That level was the beginning phases. At that level was where we pretty much started from the bottom, and we had two people that, in my mind, that would come together cohesively and build something on one accord. But this is the thing. That person didn't have the dedication and loyalty. The royalty, like I had. Whenever you mate with somebody and you're having two, you have to have two willing parties willing to contribute to the bottom factor to get an accomplished goal. Mm-hmm. If you don't have that and someone leads you in the process, you have to make the decision to keep moving forward beyond that. And so that's what I did. I made the decision to keep moving forward. And it's been an 8-year process, and I'm still single. And I don't plan on getting married or getting involved in any other relationship until I've reached the desired accomplished goal in my accolades.
Okay, and what are you trying to accomplish? What is that goal?
Of course, I'm the highest level of education in my doctoral degree. I have a business that I'm trying to run, and a book that I'm in the process of publishing, My Brains Over Body, my nonprofit organization. Mm-hmm. And so, to me, that separation, this 8-year period, was an opportunity for me to find out exactly what I was called to do. And God, you know, and it comes from a relationship with God. I had an opportunity to cultivate my relationship with God, and during this time, He revealed things to me, and so. Now I'm at the place, instead of looking for a mate, I'm looking for my purpose. I'm looking for my calling and who becoming a woman that I know I can be and reach my full potential. So if a man comes along, then he has to be willing to bring what I have or more to the table. If not, then I'll just stay by myself. And this is the personal decision that I've decided to make at this point.
So wait a minute now. So that almost got by me, but it didn't. So he has to come to the table and bring as much as you have or more. Is that what you're saying?
Exactly. Absolutely.
So who is that man then? Is that man an individual that does not have a formal education, or what if that man is let's say a blue collar worker that let's say he's works in garbage collection?
It's so interesting because in my sociology class, we're actually studying the social classism within races and blue collar and pink collar and white collar. Mm-hmm. To be honest, I never had a type, or I never disengaged from people because of their working class. Mm-hmm. I was always attracted to ambition and drive.
So the guy that's working at McDonald's right now, mm-hmm. he can come up to you and he can get a date.
Well, the Bible says the man and woman, people have to be equally yoked. There's got to be something that's equally yoking us together.
Ambition is equally yoking. He may want to be the manager of McDonald's. So is ambition not equally yoking? You're ambitious, he's ambitious. You know, now it may not be in the same exact direction as your ambition,
right.
but there's some ambitious yokes there. Is that... McDonald's worker.
It's a case by case scenario. At one point, now 10 years ago, if you would have asked me the same question, it would have been absolutely. Because of what I experienced as a single mother and the struggles I had to endure on my own, my standards are high. I'm not high maintenance, but I do have high standards, and you got to come with it. And if you're not ambitious enough and you're not bringing the same drive that I have, it's more than likely we're not going to work out. And there's something that's just how it
is. Will it not work out because you're just not allowing it to work out, or will it not work out just because of the different levels of standards?
Well,
it is what it is. If that's what it is, that's what it is. But that may be a contributing factor as to why you are single.
The standards could be a contributing factor, but you know what? Why settle? Why would I settle for somebody? Somebody else is going to get the progressive accomplishment. Why can't I can't get that? Why do I have to lower my standards and say that person for somebody else? Because I have high standards. I'm not going to degrade my standards just to accept somebody else who's not willing to have ambitions to move forward in life. You know, it's just my standards rose because of the struggles I had to endure. I have a legitimate reason to have higher standards now. And I know in order to attract that, I myself have to be in a position. That's why I'm working hard every day to get my education, to get my business, to get out here and grind and be where I need to be. So when that person come, we're equally yoked. And me having standards, there's not an issue because I'm already there.
Right, so are the days of women helping to build a man, are them days over with?
No, absolutely not. You know, I always consider myself being a contributing factor or an asset to a mate. I see myself being the mate they can bring to the bottom line. Let me add to you, not deplete. I'm not a leech. I'm not here to take away or suck up. However, you have to be a contributing factor as well. No woman falls in love with a man she cannot learn from, period. If you're not bringing any value or wisdom that can help me, teach me to get to where you are, then we don't really have anything in common. That's just my personality. That's who I am. I'm a leader. I'm attracted to leaders. I'm attracted to go-getters. That's just my human characteristics. That's how God made me, and I'm not apologizing for that.
No apologies. No apologies from Rebecca Hart. Rebecca Hart. So the poor guy at McDonald's, no shot.
If he's aiming to own the corporation or a chain of McDonald's, then we're on a different level. It goes back to the mindset and the personal ambition of that person. You know, now I can kind of push you and pray for you and cover you in the spirit, and I hook up with you 10 years later, but I don't know about the Antonio.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. McDonald's guys, I'm rooting for you out there. Look, we're coming right back, and we're going to have Rebecca Hart join us for another segment. Interesting conversation. She's saying it's standards. And, you know, maybe it's the standards that's keeping her single also. But don't go anywhere. We'll be right back right here on the Antonio Parkinson Project.
Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Theirs was. Black Market Strategies, the new face of urban marketing. Let us plan your next big event or design that special flyer. Black Market Strategies specializes in street team deployment, flyer distribution, target marketing, product and event promotions, marketing and brand awareness, campaigns and election strategies. But wait, there's more. Media relations and solutions, business strategies, community marketing. We promote people, product, events, and brands. Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Give us a call today. 901-379-9101.
Skinny Fiber works. I've got my Skinny Fiber. Have you got yours? If you need to drop 5 pounds quickly, Skinny Fiber works. If you need to get in that little black dress, Skinny Fiber works. Skinny Fiber lets you eat less and feel full. It's 100% all natural. It detoxifies the body, improves blood sugar imbalances, and melts away stubborn fat. Get yours today. For more information, call 901-860-5110. Or you may check out our website at www.skinnyuniverse.com.
Hi, I'm Antonio Parkinson. Join me for the Antonio Parkinson Project. Each and every Thursday at 5:30 p.m. on Comcast Channel 31. Black Market TV. Welcome back to the show. I'm Antonio Parkinson, and you are on the Antonio Parkinson Project, and we are talking about successful, educated, sexy, single women that say there's a reason for their singleness, if there is such a word. And joining us, she's back again, Rebecca Hart. Rebecca, welcome back to the show.
Thanks for having me. I'm still here.
And don't forget, if you want to tweet Rebecca right now, right here. Tweet her at Parkinson Project, Parkinson Project, and ask her what you want, and she'll answer, or we'll answer for her if she doesn't answer. Rebecca, getting into your purpose.
Okay.
You know, working on your book.
Yes.
You know, obviously beautiful.
Yes.
You know, single.
Absolutely.
Educated.
Mm-hmm.
No man.
No man.
We were talking about standards earlier.
Yes.
Right, so the standards, you know, and you said, you know, you have I don't want to call them lofty. You really didn't describe how high they were.
Right.
But they may be out of reach for some. Is that correct? Am I correct in saying that?
It's dependent on the person and the perception of the individual.
Okay, the person and the perception of the individual.
Exactly.
Okay. And so you part of your reason for being single is because you're mm-hmm. working on your purpose and
exactly.
you know and the things and your goals and the things that you want
right.
you want to. You know, get accomplished, right?
Exactly.
You
absolutely.
Know I'm setting you up here. It's the setup.
Well, you know, it's all good and everybody, you know, you know, but there's a reason for my standards and there's a reason for the particular height of my standards. It's because of what I had to endure as a single mother for 8 years because I had a relationship that failed and another person decided not to follow through, which left me in a situation to where I had to step my game up a notch.
But is that the reason why you are single? Is it because of that past relationship? Is that the reason why there's no man today?
Not directly, it's sort of indirectly at the reason I made the decision to focus on myself. Yes, so kind of indirectly, yes, that is a decision. But the reason why my standards are set higher is because I lowered my standards, so to speak, to accommodate a relationship that actually left me in a detrimental situation. So, of course, my standards are going to be higher than this time around. It's just unnatural. I mean, why would I go backwards?
Some would call that baggage. What do you say to that?
You know, again, it's to each his own perception.
Right.
Some would say tomato, some to model. It depends.
Some would say that you're bringing the baggage over from the previous relationship into this relationship.
Not necessarily, because the baggage I had at that particular time doesn't equate to where I am and who I am as an individual woman now. Right now, I'm a woman with power, with purpose, is going into destiny. So right now, if you're coming to me, if you're not talking about going into purpose and achieving what your assignment is on in this earth, then you have nothing to contribute to my bottom factor, you know. God said he created a helpmate for his mate. So why would God send me someone who has no idea of their identity or purpose in life, but yet me as an individual woman has the capability to pursue these endeavors on my own? So why would God send me someone that's not equally yoked? That doesn't make sense. That's spiritual. That's not even a spiritual protocol.
But he said that helpmate or that person that was fit for that other person was actually the woman fit for the man.
And you just said it in reverse to where.
Well,
you know, so is the man supposed to be fit for you in his divine purpose, or is it supposed to be the opposite?
Bible says do not be unequally yoked.
Right,
so
I got you.
Quite okay. Naturally, if I'm already there in a specific, whatever that level is, it could be low, medium, high, whatever. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying it has to be extraordinary or out of reach, but whatever level I am at the time, I know that God is going to send me a mate, or I will be a helpmate. Let me reiterate. To that person, and I'm going to bring to the add to the contributing factor. I'm not going to deplete it. I'm only going to add it or accentuate. And if I'm ambitious, if I'm achieving these certain goals, then quite naturally, God's going to send me someone to accommodate me. Does that make sense? I mean, it's just a lot.
Well, we hope he does. But you know, on the same token, in regards to the standards being set, what if there are men that decide that they won't date you because their standards are higher?
Well, I've had men to reject me.
What?
Yes, absolutely. I have in my process of my 8-year journey, and that's going to go out on the book, The Brains Over Body, where I'm teaching women how to stay focused on your assignment, even though men reject you. I've had men in high profile positions that they would never say directly, but I knew indirectly because I was a single mother, there was a strike. Because I didn't have an education, there was a strike. But in that rejection, God revealed purpose for me, and it pushed me to elevate me to be the woman of high caliber that I am possessing to become now. So thank you for the rejection, men. They know who they are if they're watching this show.
Oh, well, man, thank you. Well,
so, yeah, I mean, it's a reason for everything. So my standards are always stemmed for something that I went through in my past in rejection. God can always reveal purpose out of rejection. Always remember that. So what if they rejected you? It should make you propel to have higher standards and push yourself to be the best person that you could be.
So, okay, Rebecca, you're single?
Yes.
Would you approach a man if you wanted to date him?
Never. I will flirt, but I will never. The Bible says a man that finds a wife finds a good thing and obtain favor from the Lord. It's spiritual protocol for a man to pursue a wife. I would never pursue a man, and that's one of the things that I learned. Now, 10 years ago, it was different. I would be the initiated aggressor, and it left me nowhere. As you see now, 10 years later, and I'm still single. So, no, we learn from our mistakes.
But that same thing can happen with someone that pursues you. You know, someone can pursue you, and it still not work out. But why not go forward what you want?
Like I said, it's a human nature for a man to be the aggressor, to be the challenger, pursuer. If a woman pursues a man, you never leave the option open to know if the man actually was interested in you. Because if I'm pursuing you, and I'm the initiator, I'm the aggressor, and then the relationship falls apart. Well, I never gave you an opportunity to pursue. I never gave you a chance. I never saw you pursue me. I don't know really if you're really into me because I was the aggressor. Does it make sense? So, you have to leave the table open or the option open for the man to pursue you. It just has to go. That's how God ordained it. You cannot go negate the spiritual protocol.
So,
it can't happen.
So if you see this man that appears to be perfect for your purpose and you know, he has all of the attributes that you want. In fact, what do you want?
That's a good question.
Well, you know, someone needs to know that. I mean, you know, especially you, if you know, if there's a man out there for you, what is it that you're looking for?
I want my equal. I want someone that can teach me. No man can fall. No woman can fall in love with a man that she can't learn from. Not a wise woman. So if you have something that you can show me and teach me and help propel me and be the best woman that I can be, then I'm all ears because I want to be a positive contributor to the bottom line. I'm not here. I'm not a leech. I'm not here to take away. I'm not a gold digger, even though I have high standards. There's a difference between a gold digger and a woman with high standards.
What's the difference?
The gold digger is just there for herself. She's selfish. She's there just to take and not add to the contributing factor. Mm-hmm. A woman of high class caliber and standards, a woman of wisdom, a godly woman will add. And it doesn't necessarily have to be financial attributes. It can be spiritual wisdom. It can be emotional. It can be just a supporting factor. Loyalty. A woman with a good heart is so hard to come by. And that's all.
That's true.
That's why I'm writing the book, Brains Over Body. I'm trying to empower women to use their creative ingenuity and the education and the intellect that God gave them before a man even steps up on the scene. So if a woman is already in position and already have these attributes in place, when a man comes along, it's just a perfect fit to the puzzle. That's why it's so important during your single phase to have these attributes and to practice that and become that woman, become the man, become the person that you want to attract. That's pretty much what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm. Would you date outside your race, Rebecca?
Yes, absolutely.
You answered that mighty quick. Have you ever?
No, but I'm thinking about it.
You're thinking about it?
I really am.
Are the standards different for someone outside of your race?
Oh, absolutely not. It remains the same.
It remains the same?
Yep, remains the same. Standards are there. I'm willing to go outside my race. but the standards would still be there.
Is there a chance or a possibility that, based on your standards, that you may miss the boat on somebody that was perfect for you?
I thought about that once or twice, but now that I looking at where I am now, then probably not, because if the wrong person at the right time can still be the wrong person, because they're not adding to the contributing factor, they're not helping you propel to be the person, they can actually hinder you and keep you in a place where you can never reach your full potential.
Rebecca, one last question. Does it ever get lonely?
Absolutely.
Oh, hey, truth is spoken here, right here on the Antonio Parkinson Project. Rebecca Hart, thank you for joining us.
We
appreciate
you. Thank you so much for having me.
Great insight.
Thank you.
So, hey, we're coming right back, and we got another sexy, single, educated, working woman, and you don't want to miss this. You don't want to miss her insight as to why things are the way they are, why she is single. So don't go anywhere. Antonio Parkinson, right here on the Antonio Parkinson Project.
Skinny fiber works. I've got my skinny fiber. Have you got yours? If you need to drop 5 pounds quickly, skinny fiber works. If you need to get in that little black dress, skinny fiber works. Skinny fiber lets you eat less and feel full. It's 100% all natural. It detoxifies the body, improves blood sugar imbalances, and melts away stubborn fat. Get yours today. For more information, call 901-860-5110. Or you may check out our website at www.skinnyuniverse.com.
Hi, I'm Antonio Parkinson. Join me for the Antonio Parkinson Project each and every Thursday at 5:30 p.m. on Comcast Channel 31.
Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Theirs was. Black Market Strategies, the new face of urban marketing. Let us plan your next big event or design that special flyer. Black Market Strategies specializes in street team deployment, flyer distribution, target marketing, product and event promotions, marketing and brand awareness, campaigns and election strategies. But wait, there's more. Media relations and solutions, business strategies, community marketing. We promote people, product, events, and brands. Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Give us a call today. 901-379-9101.
Black Market TV.
Welcome back to the Antonio Parkinson Project. I am Antonio Parkinson, and thanks for joining us. Don't forget, tweet right now. Hit us on Twitter at Parkinson Project. ParkinsonProject without the T, at Parkinson Project. Hey, joining us right now, Roxy Jefferson. She is successful. She is educated. She is hardworking, has her own business, but she is single. I mean, look at her. How does this happen? Roxy Jefferson, welcome to the show.
Hi, how are you? Thank you for inviting me.
I'm good. Happy to have you. Excited to have you. I'm sure our viewing audience is as well. Roxy, you got everything that a man can want, but yet still single. What's happening? What's going on?
Well, I hope that I have everything that a man would want, and when that day comes for me, then I'll be married. But at this time right now, I'm a single, successful individual because that is a decision that I made.
Wait a minute. Our previous guest, Rebecca Hart, said it was because of the decision she made. And you're going to say the same thing. Now we ain't all of us men out here that are watching, we're not buying it. And so it's just a decision, a decision not to be involved with someone right now, you know, with all of that. But I'm sure that you're approached on a daily basis, probably several times a day.
True.
With individuals that mm-hmm. show interest in Roxy Jefferson. Roxy Jefferson, what is it? Why is that the decision?
As a single woman at this time, I think it's a conscious decision that you make because of sometimes things that you've experienced in different relationships, a point where you may be in your career when you say successful, which will make you go to the point where you say, okay, you have to decide which one you want to spend more time in, building your career or building a relationship, which both are work.
Oh, both are work. Okay. Obviously, right now, the career is winning. The money is winning, right? You call it career. I call it money. Right? So that's outweighing.
But it's even better when you get a helpmate or helpmeet that comes along and can add to what you have.
Okay.
So that way we won't be so goal-oriented or working so hard to be so successful or to be the breadwinner. When we get that correct helpmeet that God has desired to be with us, and then we won't have to be so goal-oriented where we have to do all the work by ourselves.
So, and all of the individuals that approach you on a daily basis, has that person not approached you?
All the individuals? Uh-huh. Well, I mean, sometimes it just depends on who approaches me. Mm-hmm. Just for instance, I can give you an example. I was at the gas station pumping my gas, And I've always tell people this, when a guy asks you to pump your gas, that's not the only question that he's going to ask you. Okay. So at that point, you decide, okay, you can look at him and say, are you interested in him in any kind of way other than him just pumping your gas at this point? Now, if he comes out with the MLGW uniform, it may be different. Okay, you can see he has a job, some type of career. So you may say, hey, yes, you can pump my gas, because more than likely his next question is going to be, what is your name? Can I take you out on a date or something like that? So it just depends. You have to, like the young lady said before, set a standard for yourself, and just, you can look at things sometimes just initially and say yes or no if you want to go ahead and continue with that.
So what if he doesn't have MLGW, which is Memphis Light Gas and Water for our viewers, but what if he doesn't have the Memphis Light Gas and Water uniform on, but he has on the Subway uniform?
Well, Subway. Now, if he has Subway and he has owner under his name tag, we can definitely have a conversation just for me. Now, some people, it may be different. It just depends on where you are.
Right. And so Roxy Jefferson, and we have to do a little background here. Mm-hmm. So tell us, what is it that you do? Because we're going to have to compare apples to apples.
Woo.
And so what is it that you do? And so that our viewing audience can understand why, you know, or where you're going with these standards.
Well, as Rochelle, I'm just a wonderful individual that loves God, loves friends and family. But as Roxy Jefferson, I am a self-employed entrepreneur, a cosmetologist. And everyone knows that in a salon, any type of beauty industry, we are counselors, we're doctors, we're comedians, we're everything that people need on a daily basis, because we deal with all type of situations that people deal with. They come to us, talk to us. So, I mean, I know both sides, from a male's perspective and a female perspective.
Right. Okay. So you own your own business, and successful at it. And how long have you been doing this now?
I've been a licensed cosmetologist for 12 years.
Okay. 12 years in your own business. So someone that comes along that's starting their own business, don't meet the standard?
No, I definitely would not say that. I mean, for one, it would show me that they do have goals, mm-hmm. that they do have something that they are attending to at the time, and is is trying to project themselves to a different level.
Mm-hmm. Some will say that your standards are too high.
That's appealing to me.
That's appealing to you, but
yes,
some will say that your
definitely.
Standards are too high. So the guy with the Subway, you know, with the Subway uniform on, that may be working towards a leader or manager, no love?
No, I mean, that shows that he is... Well, let me not say no, but I'm saying that does show that he is projecting himself to a different level, that he is striving to do something more than where he is. Mm-hmm. You can't just get complacent in what you're doing.
I agree with that, but when you see him asking to pump your gas and he has the Subway logo on, you know, he wouldn't even get a shot at continuing. He wouldn't even be allowed to pump your gas.
Now, if he has owner under the table, we could talk.
Right. When Mr. MLGW comes along and... You know, he got the, you know, Memphis Light Gas and Water, you know, logo on his shirt. He comes along and he can pump your gas.
Well, it just depends. Now, if you check your stats and you know your business on how much an MLGW worker makes, then you can, you know, decide then on if you want to continue on a conversation. Not that you're basing your relationship on finances, but you want to meet somebody who can be able to take care of you at some point if you're going to build a relationship with them.
But what if the Subway worker, what if he is the perfect person outside of his financial side, but everything else, and where does caring and love and all of that fit into this? Does it even fit into it?
I think all those beautiful things come with time. Mm-hmm. Maybe the setting may not be right at the gas station. For me, I mean, it's almost like a guard is put up. When I'm at the gas station, I've had that situation so many times where a guy comes up to you and their initial approach is, hey, can I pump your gas? And not for the most reason of them actually wanting to pump your gas because you're attractive, because I can see another woman who may have on something else that I don't have on or may not look the way I'm looking at that time, and they won't ask to pump their gas. I'm like, if she was here before me, why did you ask me all of a sudden? So,
and you would probably ask them that, wouldn't you?
I would.
So
if I have the time, I say, well, why you want to pump my gas?
Uh-huh. Roxy, yeah. You're a stylist, and you hear and see everything. So mm-hmm. So what about these women, that got men? How don't have the level of education you have, don't have the level of drive, don't have the level of ambition, don't have the their own business. They may be working in you know, or not, may not even be working,
ooh,
but
yes.
but they got a man. How do you, what's the difference? What's going on that they have men and here someone is with all of your attributes and you don't?
Well, in my chair, I've experienced all of that. The doctor who's single, the lawyer who's single, or the single parent who decides to be single, or a woman who doesn't want to work or doesn't even desire to work and who is single. Then I've experienced those same women who are in relationships but are not married. So it just depends on the individual. And I think each situation, it has its own valley of highs and lows. It just depends on what you want to involve yourself in at the time. And I say, like you said, a woman who is not working and has a man.
So the woman that does not have, you know, that's you know, doesn't have the qualifications that you have, and they have men. A lot of them do. You know, we see it all the time. They have men, and you know, it's boo season. Mm. You know, and they're booed up, Roxy. And so we're getting the wrap up sign, but Roxy, we're gonna come back and we're gonna talk more about you know, what it is that you're looking for and that you need and what this man needs to have in order to get someone like a Roxy Jefferson or a Rochelle Jefferson in her other life. And so we'll be right back. Don't go anywhere, the Antonio Parkinson Project.
Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Theirs was. Black Market Strategies, the new face of urban marketing. Let us plan your next big event or design that special flyer. Black Market Strategies specializes in street team deployment, flyer distribution, target marketing, product and event promotions, marketing and brand awareness, campaigns and election strategies. But wait, there's more. Media relations and solutions, business strategies, community marketing. We promote people, product, events, and brands. Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Give us a call today. 901-379-9101.
Skinny Fiber works. I've got my Skinny Fiber. Have you got yours? If you need to drop 5 pounds quickly, Skinny Fiber works. If you need to get in that little black dress, Skinny Fiber works. Skinny Fiber lets you eat less and feel full. It's 100% all natural. It detoxifies the body, improves blood sugar imbalances, and melts away stubborn fat. Get yours today. For more information, call 901-860-5110. Or you may check out our website at www.skinnyuniverse.com.
Hi, I'm Antonio Parkinson. Join me for the Antonio Parkinson Project. Each and every Thursday at 5:30 p.m. on Comcast Channel 31.
Black Market TV.
Welcome back to the show. I'm Antonio Parkinson, and you are on the Antonio Parkinson Project. And it's a good show. It's an interesting show. It's interesting to me anyway, because I'm getting some information that I didn't know before, digging into the lives of these sexy, educated, single women. Why are they single? Roxy Jefferson, thanks for being here. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you, and you are welcome as well.
So Roxy, it's boo season. You're supposed to be booed up. You're not booed up. What happens? It gets cold at night.
That's a stereotype.
You don't have to answer that.
Saying that it's cold is supposed to be boo season.
It's boo season, cupping season. So Roxy, you know, we're talking about the guys approaching you, you know, and you know, you were telling us about, you know, the guy that, you know, well, hypothetically anyway, approached you at the gas station. So what happened? Does he even get a response? Does he even get a look?
A very small response. You can't put a lot of time into it. Like I said, I wasn't really interested. I was actually on my way to work. So, I mean, at the time, all I could say was no thanks. So the automatic clicker on the gas and get in the car.
Wow. So no thanks. Did you even look at him?
I did look at him.
You looked at him?
But if I saw him again, I probably would know who he was.
Right. Did you size him up?
Not necessarily. He was speaking through his window. That was something else that was unattractive.
Was that a strike?
It was.
That was a strike.
If you was ready to pump my gas, you would be out.
What are other strikes, Roxy? What are other strikes?
When you're not being a gentleman, and I think something like that, if you really wanted to pump my gas, you wouldn't be on your phone in your car talking through your window.
Right. What are things that get you in? What does a man have to have to even get through the first layer, that first, you know, 2 minutes. You know, that first 2 minutes is the toughest 2 minutes.
Right. Well, something that softens me is a man who can dress well.
Oh.
You smell good.
Okay.
I mean, that's something that initially you look at and you kind of say, okay, raise an eyebrow. Then if you can see, with the first 2 minutes, you can see if a person has goals or some type of career about their, something about themselves that brings your attention to them.
You know, they say a woman knows within the first 5 minutes whether or not, you know, she would be interested in that person. Is there any truth to that?
First 5 minutes, somewhat, but ultimately just knowing if he's the man for you, I can't agree with that.
Right. So what, Roxy, what is it that you're looking for? What is it that that man has to possess in order to you know, even be considered as someone that you would date?
Well, that's a good question. Actually, right now I'm not looking. So hopefully the man who God has designed for me is looking for me, which is said in the Word of God that a man who finds his wife, and so if I'm at the right place at the right time and doing what I need to be doing, then he'll find me.
That was a good political answer, but you sure know, I'm sure you know what you like. So what is it that you like?
I do know what I like, yes. Yeah. That doesn't negate the fact that I do know
okay,
what I
so
like.
Okay, so what is it that you like? What
and
is
as
it
I said
that...
before, I like a man who can approach me with respect, for one, smelling good, looking good, knows what to say, knows how to play his part, and once we engage into conversation, I will also find out some things about him that could make me want to pay more attention to what he's saying.
Bad boys or good guys?
A little bit of both, actually.
A little bit of both.
Mm-hmm.
Like them a little rough around the edges?
Not too rough.
Not too rough.
Mm-hmm. Nice right. Fade, no braids.
Nice fade, no braids.
Right.
Right. So has this individual not approached you in the last year?
What, the fade or the braids?
Either. You know,
actually. Yeah, well, now dreads are so popular, so it's right. Been a lot of that coming along.
Right, but that person that fits, you know, your you know, that mold that you're looking for.
Well, I can't say that I actually have a design mold for a man who I want to be with. God is the one who can make the mold for me.
Right.
I know what I like. I know what I desire. I know what I pray for. But me actually having a mold of the man, which is, you know, we all want a tall, dark, handsome man who's going to come and sweep us off our feet into heaven and do everything that we would desire for him to do. But is that really going to happen? We do not know.
Right. But could a short, stubby, chubby man sweep you off your feet?
Oh, yeah. Stubby and chubby could do it, too. He's just going to have to work a little harder because, of course, with the human eye, I mean, the first thing we do is, you know, it's perception, what we see. So we're going to look and...
Well, that's
in most cases,
honesty.
If you're not desiring with that eye,
that's some brutal honesty right there. So, Roxy, you know, previous relationship, how long has it been since you've dated someone?
It's been a little bit over a year.
A little bit over a year.
Uh-huh.
And so, obviously, he must have been doing a little sweeping because you dated him. He got in. He got through that first layer.
Uh-huh.
You know, possibly the second layer. Did he get into that second layer that inside? And you know, how long did you date him?
It depends, first of all, on what the layers are you're speaking of.
Well, obviously, the first layer is at least even getting a conversation.
Right.
So he obviously got that. You know, how long did y'all date, though?
We got as far as even talking about marriage,
okay.
Speaking about engagement. We got to that point of our relationship where we were just communicating on it, which is a good thing to actually just ask questions, talk to the individual to see what it is that they desire in a wife that they would have for themselves.
Right. So you that's pretty deep now.
Yeah, that's
true. Yeah, that's, you know, y'all went there. Y'all went there. Mm-hmm. So, and but he's not here now. So what? Why is he not here? What,
well, things happened.
What were the standards? What did he have that allowed him to get inside with Roxy Jefferson?
He approached me the right way. First of all, for one thing, he loves God. He loved God. So with me, I'm a church going person. I want my spirit to be connected with the individual that I'm going to be with. So hopefully that we're on one accord in that position. So that was the number one thing that led me to that individual.
Oh, so the young pastor that comes along, you know, there's a chance. Right. For all you pastors out there that's watching.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I'm just
Lord,
kidding.
You hear them.
Right. But obviously, you know, but you know, what about those guys that come along? They come along and they profess church, you know, because see, men tend to send their forward team. And have you seen that before? Where they send the forward team and then after a few months of being with them, then all of a sudden you see who the real person is?
Right, yes. And even for some people, it doesn't take months. Actually, a couple of days or a couple of weeks. And you can tell that, okay, maybe this is something that I don't want to engage in anymore.
Okay. So, Roxy Jefferson.
So me with timing, patience, mm-hmm. and... You know, him saying, but also along with saying, you have to be able to do what you're saying that you're able to do.
Right. So, Roxy Jefferson, again, it's boo season. you know, and time is ticking. So are there any, you know, any goals in here? You're setting a goal for a certain time to have a man or get married or anything like that?
Well, I'm not going to say I'm setting a goal to have a man. Like you said, this show is about successful singles. So I'm setting goals as far as my career, as far as a relationship right now. I do desire, my heart's desire is to be with a man. That's what God wants for each woman, to find that companion or that companion to find them, and them to be in a marriage and to have a family and to grow in the universe. That's what we're here for. We came from a man. We came from his rib. So we're supposed to be with him. That's just God's desire for us. So, yes, I definitely desire to be married and have a husband one day.
All right. And my producer is giving us the wrap up, the cut, but I got to ask this last question. Would you ever consider lowering your standards to get the man that you want?
Oh, lower my standards? I don't think that would be a good idea.
All right. Hey, we're going to be right back. Roxy Jefferson, thank you for being on the show.
You're welcome.
It's been awesome having you, and we'll have you back. We're going to be right back. We're going to talk to a woman that has her man. And so stick around. Don't go anywhere. It's the Antonio Parkinson Project.
Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Theirs was. Black Market Strategies, the new face of urban marketing. Let us plan your next big event or design that special flyer. Black Market Strategies specializes in street team deployment, flyer distribution, target marketing, product and event promotions, marketing and brand awareness, campaigns and election strategies. But wait, there's more. Media relations and solutions, business strategies, community marketing. We promote people, product, events, and brands. Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Give us a call today. 901-379-9101.
Skinny Fiber works. I've got my Skinny Fiber. Have you got yours? If you need to drop 5 pounds quickly, Skinny Fiber works. If you need to get in that little black dress, Skinny Fiber works. Skinny Fiber lets you eat less and feel full. It's 100% all natural. It detoxifies the body, improves blood sugar imbalances, and melts away stubborn fat. Get yours today. For more information, call 901-860-5110. Or you may check out our website at www.skinnyuniverse.com.
Black Market TV.
Welcome back to the Antonio Parkinson Project. I am Antonio Parkinson. Follow us right now on Twitter at Parkinson Project, PARKINSONPROJEC without the T. We're talking about women, successful, educated. It's boo season. They have no boo. Boo hoo. We have another guest that has our boo. It's boo season. Portia Jones. You booed up?
Yes.
Sum it up in one word. Yes. I am booed up. So you booed up. You got your boo, right?
Yeah.
Right? And you don't have a college education.
Right.
Right? Been through cosmetology school.
Right.
Right? And so you got your boo. What's the difference? How did it happen? How'd you get booed up for boo season?
I have my standards. I have what I want already in my mind. And what I want is what I put out there. So I let them know up front what I want, what I expect, and that's what I got.
So what is it that you wanted and expected? Because you're married, right?
Right.
Right. So you know, not this is not a temporary boo. This is boo boo.
Right.
Right. So you booed up. You married. What? How did that happen? How did you get there? Because and the reason why I'm asking is because you know we had other guests on here that you know have a lot going and you know they you know are still booless.
Right.
So what happened? How did it happen for you?
Well, it started off with how he came to me, and if he really is serious, he always gonna come correct.
Right, right. Standards. You know, were there certain standards that you were expecting, or certain standards that you wouldn't go below? What wouldn't you accept? What would you not accept?
I wouldn't accept anybody who is not career purpose. Like, don't have anything for themselves in the future, mm-hmm. who don't set their standards, or who just, you know, living life as a lump on a log.
That's interesting. So now, what advice do you have for those women that are not booed up?
I just wait. You know, mm-hmm. it's better to wait. You don't want to jump in nothing too quick because you don't want to regret it. So just wait, because mm-hmm. everybody has their season. You know. Just stay prayed up, you know, just know what you want, and you already know he's going to fulfill your heart's desire, because everybody deserves to be with someone. Everybody deserves to be loved.
Okay, Portia, now we talked about those that those individuals that say they're looking for what they're looking for. But what if what you're looking for is not what God had for you?
I just say that if it's not what Jesus has for me, then it will reveal itself at the end, because does nothing play out whatever God has for you. It doesn't, it lasts a long time, but what he doesn't have for you don't last a long time. So if it ends, then, you know, it wasn't for me.
Yeah, because, you know, that mistake has been made, and a lot of people have suffered many years of transgression. For picking that person that they thought was the person that they wanted, or the person that was for them, but in reality that wasn't who God had for them.
Right.
And you know, that's a tough mistake, because you get in there and you get that individual and you have a baby with that individual. It's 20 years, baby, 20 years strong of misery.
Yeah, that's why I always tell people you should wait, because you don't know everything from that person off the top. It's a learning process. So you always, whoever you get into a relationship, you always have to grow. So, you know, before you make that commitment, make sure that's who you're willing to go through any and everything with, you know, to make the relationship right. Because you're going to go through any relationship. You know, so just make sure that's the person you're willing to go through with.
But, you know, okay, so you booed up, and some of our previous guests are not, but it hadn't always been that way. So what happened? What happened in those previous relationships before you got permanently booed?
Previous relationships, I always thought people was the one who wasn't the one.
The one.
Yes, and they wasn't the one, you know. In time you tell, so, you know, when you go through stuff, you just say, okay, if he's doing this or doing that, you already know that's not the person for you, because you already been through that, or you already thought that there was the one that was it for you.
So there was a standard building. What kind of individuals were the ones before the one?
Don't know how to talk to you, respect for one, perspective, how you dress, how you carry yourself, how you treat your lady, how you treat your mom, because how you treat your mom is how you're going to treat the next lady. So all of that comes up with standards as well.
Right. They say some women tend to go after men that's like their father. Any truth to that?
Somewhat truth. It depends on what the child took from the father. You know, child can take all the good things from the father and want that out of a man. But, you know, hey, they might.
Well, before you were permanently booed, were you lacking standards? Do you think you were lacking standards in the individuals that you were dating, or were you still trying to discover what your standards were? You're fairly young. How old are you, Portia? You're fairly young.
I'm 23.
Okay, you're 23. So, So before you got married,
right.
Were you still trying to find what those standards were?
Not before I got married. Before I got married, I already knew what it was. But as I was growing up and was able to have relationships, then yes, I was starting to build up what I like and what I don't like and what I'm looking for and, you know, what I want to have in my future.
Portia Jones, she is booed up. And you know, and her standards are still her standards, and you know, we appreciate you being on the show. First time on the show, right?
Right. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, we're gonna have to have you back. You know, you represent the Booed Up group, and so thank you again. Thank you for sharing your information, your story with us, and we'll be right back on the Antonio Parkinson Project. Okay. Don't go anywhere. Stay right there where you are, because we got Brandi J. Flynn coming to the Antonio Parkinson Project, and she is going to pull all of this stuff together for us and put it in a ball so we can all swallow it and make it palatable. So stick around. It's the Antonio Parkinson Project, and we will be right back. Welcome back to the Antonio Parkinson Project. I am Antonio Parkinson. It's been a good show. And we're talking about single women, single, sexy, educated, motivated, ambitious women, not just your average single woman. But why are they single? You have all these attributes. Why are you single? And so don't forget, hit us right now on Twitter. Ask the questions that you want. We are at Parkinson Project, P-A-R-K-I-N-S-O-N-P-R-O-J-E-C without the T. Join us right now, Brandy Flynn. Brandy J. Flynn. Brandy, welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you for having me.
So, Brandy, you've been hearing what's going on. They're sexy, they're educated, they're motivated, they're ambitious, and a whole host of other things, but yet they are single. What's going on with them, Brandy?
Well, I can't necessarily say what's wrong with them, but as I was listening to each and everyone's story, I did pick up some certain things about what could be the reason why they're single. But all of them stated that they choose to be single. It's, none of them said that they, you know, got turned down from anybody, whatever like that. Each of the ladies that are single stated that that's what they choose to be.
Yeah, and
so
Brandon,
let's get
and Brandon,
that straight.
And Brandon, we choose not to believe that. So what's so, Brandon? I'm just kidding. You know,
okay.
I'm just giving them a hard time. But Brandon, they are single. But why is that? Are there not enough men? Are there not enough right men? You know, and I see this so much. I see so much of this. You know, our professional women.
Right.
You know, our nurses, our educators. You know, our stylists. You know, our authors, book writers, and they're beautiful, but they're single, as single can be.
All right.
So what's going on, Brandy? Why, tell me, help us.
Well, I think one of the reasons why a lot of women at their status are not single is because they want to get somebody that looks good on paper.
Oh.
You know,
mm-hmm.
I have this, he has this.
Mm-hmm.
I go to church, he goes to church. I have a degree, he has a degree. I have no kids, he has no kids.
But is that always good?
No. You know, because people have to realize you can look good on paper, but you may not look good together in real life. What's lacking is the chemistry and compatibility.
Mm.
Because just because you have a degree does not mean you're going to get that good job. And even though you do have that good job, you may lose it. So you have to find somebody who is compatible with you. Because
oh
what are you going to do if they lose that job?
That's a good point. That's why you are the counselor.
Yes, that's the reason.
Right.
I'm the counselor.
Brandon, and let the people know what it is that you do, because that's some good sound information. And actually, I hadn't even thought about it.
Yeah, well, I'm a mental health counselor and consultant. I work with people in the entertainment industry and athletes, but I also work with everyday people, and I deal with people with real life issues.
Mm-hmm. And this is a real life issue.
It is. It is.
You know, some of these women can continue on into oblivion with absolutely no mate. Is that a possibility? Is that a reality?
It's a possibility, but I don't think this is what, you know, the women that were on here, that's what they want.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but hopefully it doesn't take them till they're in their 50s and 60s to realize, you know, what they could have, because we have to realize, just like for me, I'm educated, but my education is for me. It's not, okay, I have this, so in order for you to date me, you have to have this.
What is that purpose? What are you dating for?
I'm dating for marriage.
You're dating for marriage. Does that run men off? Do you tell them that?
You know what? Honestly, I do. Yeah. I don't tell them, like, you're the person, you know, oh, I'm going to date you to see if we're getting married. I mean, no, that's not the first date conversation.
How do you tell a man that, hey, we're on this date, and they say, what's your five-year plan? How do you answer that? Do you say, in 5 years, I plan to be married?
Yeah.
Last date.
And you know, but you know what? Honestly.
I'm just kidding.
Honestly, that's not true.
That's not, I'm just kidding.
Not for me. That's not true, because I feel like this, that's not all I talk about.
Mm-hmm.
I talk about everything else. Honestly, in my experience, because just like how you feel like women can be gold diggers, you have men that do the same thing. I have men to try to be with me just because of what I have going on, because they look at the compatibility. I've met men that were educated, that had this and had that, but you know what? The chemistry was not there. So I'm not going to date you just because we have the same thing. I want to date you because I like you, because I love you, because I want to see your face.
Mm-hmm.
When I wake up in the morning.
But could that be the McDonald's worker?
You know, it possibly could be. But I'm going to tell you this, being the type of woman that I am, and if he knows that he has a good woman, he knows that I have great goals, he's not going to want to stay at McDonald's. Because he's going to say, hey, you know what? She got this, she got that. in order for me to be with her, I need to make some more changes. And you know, Antonio, I actually had a guy like that. Right. I dated a guy. Uh-huh. He went to college, but he didn't finish. But when we started dating, and I had my master's degree, he was just like, I need to go ahead and finish my degree. How am I going to date somebody got a master's degree and I don't even have my degree?
Right. Well, you got a master's degree, but could it be the guy that dropped out of high school? How low will your standards go?
You know what? It depends on his story.
Oh, really?
I'm the type of person.
Now, you're going to have to make me believe this one, Brandy.
Oh, okay. Okay. It depends on his story. We can't generalize everything. Mm-hmm. Everybody is not, doesn't fit the mold.
Right. Well, will he even get an opportunity to tell his story?
I would give him an opportunity to tell the story. Right. That's just me personally. That's mm-hmm. not me, the educated female. Mm-hmm. That's me bringing Brandy J.
Oh, just the analytical, digging in, one of the curious.
Because Brandy. My thing is right. this. It's another C. I spoke about, you know, compatibility, chemistry. It's also conversation.
Mm. Conversation rules the nation.
Yes. If you have a great conversation, and if I'm intrigued about you, I'm going to want to know more about you. Because, honestly, there's a lot of people who are successful who do not have a high school diploma.
Right. And I think I read somewhere here recently that it said the majority of millionaires didn't even finish college.
Exactly. But right. there are also millionaires, black millionaires, who do not have a high school diploma.
Right. There are. There are.
But if you're going to be with me, you want to go back and get it.
You want to go back and get it?
Yes.
Yeah, Brandy J. Flynn. So, Brandy.
Yes.
What advice do you have to these... These successful, educated, sexy, beautiful, but single women that are, it's cold out there right now. You know, it's boo season. What do they do?
Well, what I will say to the ladies is this, you know, date a person for who they are and not what they are.
Right.
Because their title can change. Their CEO can be knocked down real quick. And then if he does, then what are you going to do? Are you going to leave him?
Wow.
So you need to date. You need to find out who the person is.
Right. And take the time to find out who that
exactly.
person is. You still have to take the time to dig into and see, you know, what each individual is about individually. Brandy J. Flynn, thank you for joining us on the
show.
Thank
you for having me.
Great insight. We appreciate you being here. And Brandy, you know, we're going to have to you're going to become a recurring person on this show. I see it now. I see it coming.
I would love to.
It's going to happen. You've been awesome. Look, make sure you tune in this time next Thursday right here on Comcast Channel 31, or hit us right here on blackmarkettv.com. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter at Parkinson Project, PARKINSONPROJEC. I am Antonio Parkinson, and you have been on The Antonio Parkinson Project. We'll see you next week.
Powered by Black Market Strategies.
Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Theirs was. Black Market Strategies, the new face of urban marketing. Let us plan your next big event or design that special flyer. Black Market Strategies specializes in street team deployment, flyer distribution, target marketing, product and event promotions, marketing and brand awareness, campaigns and election strategies. But wait, there's more. Media relations and solutions, business strategies, community marketing. We promote people, product, events, and brands. Is your event powered by Black Market Strategies? Give us a call today. 901-379-9101.
Skinny Fiber works. I've got my Skinny Fiber. Have you got yours? If you need to drop 5 pounds quickly, Skinny Fiber works. If you need to get in that little black dress, Skinny Fiber works. Skinny Fiber lets you eat less and feel full. It's 100% all natural. It detoxifies the body, improves blood sugar imbalances, and melts away stubborn fat. Get yours today. For more information, call 901-860-5110. Or you may check out our website at www.skinnyuniverse.com.
Hi, I'm Antonio Parkinson. Join me for the Antonio Parkinson Project each and every Thursday at 5:30 p.m. on Comcast Channel 31.